Nikunj Ohri caught up with Ajay Bhushan Pandey, the GSTN chairman, to find exactly how the system helps the taxman crack down errant flares.
GSTN system, the way it has been rolled out and is unified, because all the returns get filed onto one system. So it also gets automatically cross-checked. For example, if somebody has sold goods to somebody, then in the buyer's returns, you know, all these transactions should get reflected, right? And so this is the kind of the cross verification that goes on, right? And you know what we do is that by using several algorithms, right, we are trying to figure out that what is the where all the tax compliance issues are there, and there the appropriate. So what we do is that based on such analysis, that if we find any discrepancy, that somebody has sold the goods to someone, and then either the seller or purchaser has not disclosed that transaction, because any transaction involves two sides, seller and purchaser, and this that transaction should get reflected in the returns of both the dealers, right? So wherever there is a mismatch, we are in a position to find out, and then accordingly go back to the dealer and try and see that whether it was a inadvertent mistake, they could correct that. And if there are compliance issues, then the appropriate proceedings under the law, which is available under the GST law, that could be taken by the tax authorities. So the whole idea is that the GSTN system simplifies the tax filing process, and also it encourages the honest taxpayers. Because if these honest taxpayers, they can file the return, and then absolutely no manual interface, right? And at the same time, it also improves the compliance, because if people know that the entire system is such that it is very, very difficult for anyone to hide those transactions, then naturally the people will be tempted to report the correct things, and that is how the whole the compliance will improve.
And sir, also, has the government or GSTN been able to find out why is there still a significant gap in the number of taxpayers who are registered under GSTN and those who file their tax returns on a monthly basis? There seems to be still a significant gap in the two. So have you been able to find out the reason as to why this is happening?
You see, if you see historically, the people take registrations under the various tax system. For example, when the VAT used to be there or service tax used to be there, that time people used to take a registration, right? Now, when they take a registration, and supposing if there are no transactions, then the tendency is to not to file the returns, right? And if you compare the figures that, in the earlier system, let's say in a particular state, how many people were registered under the VAT system and how many people were actually filing the return. And if you make a comparison, there is a definite improvement in terms of comparison with the the earlier system. So there is an improvement, and then our endeavor will be that each dealer, even if he has to file a nil returns, right, he should be able to file nil return by pressing just three buttons that I mentioned to you a little while ago. So the whole idea is to make the whole process so simple that a dealer who is a very small dealer, and he has to just report certain transactions, he should be able to file returns. We are also, in the new return design, what we are trying to do is that if the invoice itself, at the time of generation of the invoice, if it gets uploaded onto the GSTN portal, then the return automatically gets prepared. So one need not, go and collect the information from all the invoices and transport them onto the returns and then file, because the returns are nothing but the informations that are collected from the invoices mostly, right? So the whole idea is that when the invoices are getting generated and getting uploaded, the relevant information can be taken out from by the system to the returns, and then the returns should get auto-generated. And if there are some corrections, some adjustments are to be made, then the dealers can make them. So if we and our attempt is that if we simplify this process, and which we will do, then this will further encourage those, you know, who are not able to file returns for one reason or the other.
The GST Council had also approved a set of changes to the return filing framework. So have you initiated the work on that, and how long would those changes, how long will you take to incorporate all these changes in the current system?
Now, the GST Council took a very landmark decision to, because earlier, you know, one had to file three returns, GSTR1, GSTR2, GSTR3, and then every month. So in 1 year, 36 returns. Right? We also added GSTR3B. So, you know, in together, you know, there will be like a 48 returns, right? Now, what we are trying to do is that all these returns will be replaced by one return in a month, right? And it will be a very, very simplified system. The GST Council has approved that. We already have started the work, right? And we expect that in the next few months, we should be able to, to roll out the new return system. Parallelly, during the transition phase, you know, we will continue with GSTR3B and then the new return system. But and then at an appropriate time, you know, the GSTR3B and GSTR1 will be withdrawn, and it will be only the new return will be continued.
So GSTR3B returns would continue for some time,
you know, because we get revenue through GSTR3B, right? So whenever you try to bring in a new system, you know, there has to be a transition plan. And this is the transition plan that we had presented to the GST Council. And this is the GST Council approved this.